Very good evening to all of you. INSA senior scientists and fellows, Professor Singhvi, Professor Khurana, Dr. Asad Rehmani, Dr. Singh, ladies and gentlemen, at the outset, let me express my grateful thanks to Professor Kohli and Professor Singhvi for inviting me to this August gathering, to this symposium, which I believe is the sixth in the series. Also down the memory lane, fond memory lane, remembering Professor S.Z. Kasim, this hall, this place where we are gathered as we are today, is after that great noble soul who had done a lot of work in the area of coastal and marine issues in this country. Only when you come to a gathering like this and you stand humbly before knowledgeable people, that people like me in the government realize, and that realization dawns very easily, that how little we know sitting in the government in terms of research, in terms of modern developments, so on and so forth. So at any time, if you people wish to stop me or cut me off and ask anything, please do so. I would be very happy to answer. Now, let me take this opportunity to start by saying, what is our resource base? What is it that we are worried about in terms of coastal and marine biodiversity? A long coastline, more than 7,500 kilometers. The world's largest congregation of mangroves, shared between Bangladesh and India, 60% in Bangladesh, 40% in our country. In the Sundarbans, the half of the turtles in the world returning to the Orissa coast for mass nesting. The beautiful, majestic, gentle, giant whale shark, which comes to the coast of Gujarat for childbirth or parturition, and the sea cows in the Gulf of Mannar, sea mermaids, and of course the beautiful and striking corals. These, why am I romanticizing all this? Because this is the resource base which is at stake. This is what we need to protect. This is what we need to conserve, and the attendant ecosystems. And there is a thread of connectivity among them, as all of us as biologists know. We are a mega diverse nation, Dr. Kohli mentioned, and to what he mentioned, let me add that this country has only 2.4% of world's land area. And in this 2.4% of world's land area, what do we have? We have more than 70% of wild tigers. The wild and domesticated elephants are around 40,000. We, in this 2.4% of the land area, we have 1.3 billion of us, going stronger, meaning thereby that every sixth individual in the world that you come into contact with is a proud Indian. We have around more than 17% cattle population, and we have identified in our jungles more than 100,000 animals, 47,000 plant species, and I am told by responsible scientists that 30 to 40% of our flora, fauna are yet to be fathomed in our jungles. Dr. Rahmani is among us, and I will be doing injustice if I don't mention about more than 700 protected areas, around 18 biosphere reserves, 27 Ramsar sites, and all this we are in 2.4% of world's land area. So what is the thread of connectivity that binds us? Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, our traditions. Earth is but one family. Doesn't mean that we don't have challenges. There are a number of challenges that we face. So I thought I will list some of them. It is for you people to read. I won't read them verbatim. But just two questions. Do we know enough about marine species? I already told you about the problem that we have in terms of the species on the terrestrial. Do we know enough about marine species and the ecosystems and the ecosystem functions? Have we identified our marine flora and fauna? That's my next question to this August gathering. And I am also tempted to make here a small point in terms of microplastics issue. We have among us the director of Indian Institute of Petroleum, Dr. Anjan Ray. Ray sir, would you also say something what your institute is doing? I am told that there is some resolution which was there yesterday, kind of a statement. If you would like to say a word, because as much carbon atoms that we are wanting to import for our diesel and other fuel, the same number of those carbon atoms are already there in terms of used vegetable oil and the plastics and other the waste. Yeah. And he is the person who has perfected this technique, and he has also made the flight run between Dehradun and Delhi and demonstrated that the fuel works. So congratulations to you for converting a waste into a resource. But microplastics and plastics as such are a huge problem in the marine environment. This is about the riches that we have. I made here only one point, and that point I have to share with you is, till now this country did not have a separate Ministry of Fisheries. It was only a part of Department of Animal Husbandry, Dairy Development and that. It also used to include marine fisheries. Now we have, this year onwards, a full-fledged Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and that. That is the name. And let me now coming back again to the challenges that we face. While I was preparing, gearing up for today's presentation, I was told by my friend, Dr. Rahmani, that what if we need to sensitize as biologists, what if the temperature would change by 1 degree? What difference can it make? It can make a lot of difference. Because in animals like turtles, 1 or 2 degrees make a great difference, because the sex determination is temperature related. And if you, it's not just adjusting your air conditioner to, you know, cater to that 1 degree rise in global temperature, but it is, it would be either all useless male at the end or only females. It will interfere with their reproduction. And the same is true for a number of plants and animals. This is more out of curiosity, and I would say that nations of the world are at different stages of development. While you can't roll back the tide of history, you can moderate the flow. So we have this United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change, to which we are a party. But certainly, the problem that we are today facing, our hand as a country is minimal in that. Our per capita and cumulative emissions are very low compared to China or US or European Union, which is a conglomeration of 28 nations. But still, the point remains that excessive consumption patterns have to be avoided. A climate-friendly lifestyle is the only way, because a cocoon of luxury is not going to save anybody from the reverberations of climate change. And just one more point in this slide, that the extreme events, be it floods, drought, heat waves, they are going to stay with us in the times to come. This slide I am showing only for one seminal purpose, that there is a need for thinking conscious researchers to read these reports which are churned out internationally. These three reports have come out on climate change. One is on cryosphere and oceans, one is on land, and other is on the 1.5 degree Paris temperature goal. We have in this country very little research in terms of policy research. And I would wish to sensitize that this is the requirement, because many a times many things are said about India which may not be in the right perspective. I have taken just two examples, two ecosystems, one about mangroves, other on the coral reefs, and then I will quickly finish. And this is how would one describe mangroves. It is self-explanatory. At a time when the mangroves in the world are disappearing, India has registered between the two assessments, 2015 and 2017 assessment, a rise in 112 square kilometer of mangroves. And MSSRF, Anna University, Annamalai University, and many other institutions have their own databases and done wonderful work in this area. But we have problems of data sets. The data sets which the Forest Survey of India produces, data set which the Space Application Center Ahmedabad produces, many times these data sets don't match. We have a lot of things in mangroves. The monitor, the tiger and trees and mangroves, they all grow together. Time does not permit. These are all topics by themselves. So all of you know what happened during the 1999 super cyclone of Orissa and the 2004 December tsunami. The areas which were behind mangroves, they suffered less, and people started not waiting for any aid or otherwise, and local people started planting mangroves in the coastal regions of the country. These are some of the research findings in terms of anti-cancer compounds, so on and so forth. A lot of work has been done in past 30 years in this country. Similarly, on the oral means, I am given a sign by Dr. Kohli that I am trying to exceed my time. Just two more minutes, I make my point, you may cut me off thereafter. These are the four major reef areas, and Gulf of Mannar, Gulf of Kutch, Andaman Nicobar, Lakshadweep. These are the components which are assisted in the centrally sponsored schemes of Government of India, which one can avail for these two ecosystems. Issues and challenges are many. One small lecture like this would not be enough. There is a great need to involve private sector into all this, because they are also wanting to have their green image. But private sector participation is not that much so far. This is the way forward that we are thinking, participatory approach. While we talk of increasing the mangroves in the country, the example of Kerala is very befitting. Some years before, around 1940s or 50s, it used to have around 600 square kilometers of mangroves. Today it is the census, the remote sensing technology shows it is nearly less than 10 square kilometers. There are other pressures. The biodiversity beyond national jurisdiction is something which is being negotiated at the UNGA level. Trawling is another issue. Marine invasives, Dr. Kohli spoke of terrestrial invasives, marine invasives. Livelihoods is a big issue. And the same places which have the fish landing centers, you have ports, harbors, salt pans, and the SEZ. So there are challenges. And policy conflicts. And this is only for you people to advise me, because this is a model of a bicycle which I have used, how conservation has to go along with the economic growth. I thank you for your kind attention. I also would like to say that in this age of plastics, computers, supercomputers, missiles, and so on, we still depend on biodiversity for all our needs, our sustenance on this planet. And this is, there is no plan B, this is the only planet that we have. We know this. But what value something has which is called biodiversity, because it is taken for granted, it grows in your backyard. Thank you very much for your kind attention.